على الآيات والذكر وفي فيض من العطر هنا رمضان مدرسة تنير مآثر الفكر على الآيات والذكر وفي فيض من العطر هنا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه. My dear brothers and sisters, Ramadan is the month of Qur'an. The Qur'an is a majestic, marvelous book that one can read his entire life and never extract all of its wonders. Many times when we speak about the Qur'an, we speak about many various dimensions. We hear about the scientific miracles of the Qur'an. We hear about the wisdom of its verses and its rulings. But one of the dimensions that the Sahaba and those who were the contemporaries of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they marveled over was the linguistic and artistic beauty of the Qur'an. So today I'd like to share with you just one beautiful verse from the Qur'an that gives us this artistic flavor of the Qur'an that is meant to move the hearts, the ears, and the minds to getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surat Al A'raaf, وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَقُ مِنْهَا فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكْهُ يَلْهَثْ ذَلِكَ مَثَلُ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُصُصِ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to recite to the people the story of a man who had been granted the manifest signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a man who had been given knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he chose to detach himself from those signs. So shaitan followed and pursued this man until that man became astray. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues and said, had Allah willed, he would have raised that man up high in status. But this man chose to cling to the earth and follow his desires. So his example is like that of a dog. If you chase after him, he pants. And if you leave him alone, he pants. And that is the example of people who reject the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So recite to them the story so that perhaps they will reflect. My dear brothers and sisters, this story has a powerful parable in it. Allah tells us to think and reflect about a situation where you or me or an individual has been given knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, awareness of His beauty, of His power, of His verses. And then despite having that knowledge that is so powerful, that one chooses to shed himself of those verses the way that an animal sheds his skin. That's the choice of words Allah uses. And so if you think about your skin is one of the most important things that protects you as a human being. And that imagine how painful it would be to rip off your skin. And you'd expose yourself to so many diseases and how much pain if you removed your skin. Allah is telling us these verses and the signs of Allah are like that skin that protects us. If you try to shed them and remove them and ignore them, by some people saying, you know, this verse, I don't like this verse, I don't want to live by this verse, I want to ignore that verse. Allah says this is going to be a very painful situation. And what will happen is the shaitan will then see this person is choosing to remove the protection of the Qur'an. And the shaitan will say, this is an easy person to attack. Like the bacteria can attack the skin, your body when the skin is not there. The shaitan will attack you when you remove the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah tells us that, you know what? Allah wants us to stick firmly to the Qur'an. And if we do, He will elevate us in status by acting appropriately, by having good character, by getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we will literally get closer to heaven when we do this. But this man in the story, he chose to cling to the earth and follow his desires. So if you think about this parable, you know, birds, they soar in the air. And people marvel at the birds when they're flying in the air because of their majesty. But no one looks at a dog laying on the ground or lying in the mud and says, this is a majestic creature. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the example of a dog. That this individual who ignores the ayat of Allah and removes himself from these signs of Allah is like a dog. You know, if you see a dog, he pants in every situation. Whether you chase after the dog or you leave the dog alone, it pants. And the human being who has abandoned the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he covets the dunya. He covets the pleasures of this life. And whether or not he achieves them, he cannot get more and more. He wants more and more of it. And if you remind him of the akhirah, he still seeks this dunya. So Allah is saying to be careful, not to be like this example of this man, who in reality is more like a dog than he is to a majestic being soaring free in the sky and in the heavens towards Jannah and towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. During this blessed month of Ramadan, my brothers and sisters, I encourage you all and I encourage myself to immerse yourself in the Qur'an. Allow those verses to seep into your body and to be a part of you, just like your skin is a part of you. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us, by our attachment to the Qur'an, to be elevated in status, both in this life and the next. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته